Hey, what's up everybody? It's your girl Merle. Today we're doing something really cool. We're gonna make vegan grilled cheeses at 3 different time intervals. We're gonna make one at 5 minutes. We're gonna make one at 50 minutes. And we're gonna make one at 5 hours. So let's get to it. In this first one, we only have 5 minutes. Here we have about 4.5 ounces of tofu. You can use paper towels if you want. I'm trying to be a little more sustainable. So I'm using a cloth and I'm just gonna wrap this up like so. And now that we've got this all wrapped up, we're just gonna put a big old book or you can put a cast iron pan on top of it to help drain the liquid. While I have my tofu draining, I'm gonna go ahead and pop 2 pieces of white bread on the skillet. So these only need about a minute per side. Let's take our tofu out. Now we're gonna add this to our food processor. Some nutritional yeast, apple cider vinegar, organic sugar, refined coconut oil, and a teaspoon of salt. Let's kick that off. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking,
Merle, that is like a cream cheese. That's not a grilled cheese.
But listen, we're not copping out and doing the store-bought cheese. We're making it from scratch, so you gotta give me a little bit of flexibility here, okay? And technically, the bread is toasted, so there. If you want melty, cheesy, in the traditional sense of a grilled cheese, just wait for the next couple recipes. We're gonna transfer our cheese mixture to a bowl. Now we're just on to the final step. We're gonna add in some very thinly sliced chives, some fresh dill, and some fresh parsley. And the last bit here is assembly. We've got our 2 beautifully toasted pieces of bread. I'm gonna go ahead and spread my cheese on there, and I'm just gonna top it off with some tomato slices. And that's it. It's got the cheesy flavor from the nutritional yeast and a little bit of tang from the apple cider vinegar. It's not a grilled cheese in the traditional sense, but it only takes 5 minutes. It's very healthy. It's all healthy ingredients, and it's got some good protein to it. Woo! That is so good! Oh my gosh, really good. Really, really good. I'm very satisfied with that. Let's move on to our next one. So the thing we're gonna start with is by adding some carrots and some cashews to a medium pan, and I'm just gonna cover this with water. And then I'm gonna bring it to a boil and let it cook for about 10 minutes. Okay, so this is done. I'm going to remove the cashews and the carrots and I'm just gonna put them into my blender. We wanna use 1¾ cups of our cooking liquid. Now we're gonna add our nutritional yeast, lemon juice, some garlic powder, some turmeric, salt, and then we're gonna add our tapioca starch. Tapioca starch is a natural vegan ingredient that is derived from the cassava plant. It's found in a lot of vegan cheeses. And then finally, we're gonna add our agar-agar, which is derived from a red algae. Now we're gonna transfer our cheese to a medium pan. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna continually whisk this over a medium heat, and that heat is gonna activate the agar-agar and give it that great, gooey, stretchy, cheesy goodness. So now we're gonna transfer our mixture to a baking sheet. I've got a silicone mat, a nice zero waste option for your baking and cooking needs. We just wanna spread it out into a nice even layer. Now we're just gonna set this in the fridge to cool for about 30 to 40 minutes. And in the meantime, we're gonna make our delicious avocado salad. We're gonna start by dicing up a cucumber, put all your scraps in your little compost bowl. Don't forget to compost. All right, onto our tomatoes. We know, Merle, you've showed us 1,000 times that you can juggle, but it never stops getting cool. So now it's just time to do a really simple dressing. I'm just gonna add the juice from 1 lemon, 2 tablespoons of olive oil, salt and pepper to taste. I'm gonna use a big ol' bunch of fresh parsley, and we're just gonna mix this up. This salad is so simple and refreshing. It's the perfect addition to the side of a delicious grilled cheese. So it's time to take the cheese out of the fridge, and let's see how it looks. Look at that! Oh, yeah! Look at that! That is so cool. I'm so happy about this right now. I'm gonna take this to the skillet and then let's see how she melts. Here we have our 50-minute grilled cheese. It's looking so beautiful. It's got the melt to it. It's got the color. It's got the stretch, that amazing cheese pull. It takes under an hour to make, and you have a little extra time to make a salad on the side. We're down to our last recipe here. If you wanna do everything top to bottom, this is the grilled cheese for you. So we're pulling out all the stops for this one. We're gonna make our own bread, we're gonna make a homemade, delicious roasted tomato soup, and we're gonna make two different kinds of vegan cheese. We're gonna make a smoked Gouda and a cheddar. We got a lot of work to do, let's get into it. The first thing we gotta do is make our bread. So to start this whole thing off, I've got 2 cups of warm water, about a half a teaspoon of sugar, and finally some active dry yeast. I'm gonna let this do its thing. I'm gonna give it like 10 to 15 minutes, and when we come back, it should be all foamy and bubbly, and we can proceed. So we're looking nice and foamy in here. So now it's time to add some salt, and some bread flour, and some whole wheat flour. And now I'm gonna use my rubber spatula and I'm gonna just mix this so it all combines. I'm gonna just quickly wet my hands and I'm gonna knead it a little bit so we can work out all the dry spots. We want the dough to be a little bit wet but be able to pull away cleanly from the sides of the bowl. The next step is to just cover this bowl with a damp washcloth. And then we're gonna set it aside to proof for 80 minutes. And while the dough is rising, we're gonna make our tomato soup. The first thing we wanna do is arrange our tomatoes cut side up in a baking sheet. We're gonna season them with some salt. After that, we're gonna scatter the shallot, garlic, and thyme leaves over the tomatoes. Drizzle your olive oil evenly over everything. And then we're gonna transfer the tomatoes to the oven and bake them for 80 minutes. Now we're working on our cheeses. The first thing we wanna do is soak our cashews for our cheddar cheese. So first, we're gonna head over to the sink and we're gonna just rinse out these cashews under hot tap water. And then we're gonna cover them with fresh hot water and let those sit while we go on to make our smoked Gouda. So the first thing we're gonna do is spray our container with some non-stick spray. Then we wanna take our smoked paprika and we're just gonna add it in there. We're gonna sprinkle it in there. So we wanna make sure this is evenly distributed and fully coated. It'll all make sense soon, just trust me. I'm just gonna set this to the side for now. All right, so now we're gonna add a bunch of our ingredients into this high-speed blender. I've got some full-fat coconut milk, about 1/4 cup of filtered water, some tapioca starch, and now we're gonna add in some kappa carrageenan, and it's known as like a thickener or a binder. It's an emulsifying stabilizer, so it'll act as our gelling agent. All right, we're gonna add some nutritional yeast, some tamari, psyllium husk, sugar, garlic powder, and finally, some liquid smoke. Now I've got a medium saucepan. I'm gonna add a little bit of coconut oil to it. And we are going to transfer our mixture here into the pot. Now that we have this in here, I'm gonna turn the heat up to medium and bring this up to a simmer. And then I'm gonna turn it down to like a medium low, whisking it consistently for about 6 minutes. It's looking very, very smooth and gooey, which is exactly what we want. And now that we're done whisking, we're gonna take it off the heat and we're just gonna add a little bit of apple cider vinegar. We want that flavor to imbue itself into the cheese. And if we put it in before, it would cook right out. Okay, so now I'm just going to transfer this to my prepared container. I'm just gonna pop this in the refrigerator for about 1 hour. And in the meantime, we can move on to our cheddar cheese. So we're gonna drain the cashews that we had soaking. We're gonna add those to our blender. Then we're gonna add some really hot water, tapioca starch, kappa carrageenan, nutritional yeast, miso, some roasted red peppers, some turmeric for that great color, and finally, some salt. Now we're going to blend this all together until it's very, very smooth. We're gonna transfer this over to our medium saucepan. Ooh, pretty color. Now we're gonna add 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. And now the process is basically the same as before. Okay, so now that the bread has risen, we are going to take a rubber spatula and I'm gonna fold the dough towards the center of the bowl about 8 times. Okay, now that we're done, I'm going to cover this with a towel and set it aside to proof for one more hour. In the meantime, I'm gonna raise the temperature on my oven to 450 degrees Fahrenheit, put my Dutch oven inside there to start to heat that up. So now that the tomatoes have cooled off, I'm gonna use my fingers and I'm gonna pull the skin off and set that aside in my little compost bowl. Now we're gonna transfer the tomatoes, shallot, and garlic along with any liquid to a medium pot. So we've got all of that delicious goodness in the pot. Now we're just gonna add some vegetable broth. And I've got a cool little trick here. We're gonna add some Arborito rice. The rice is gonna thicken this soup when we blend it all together. So that's a great little vegan hack for making your soups creamier. I'm gonna bring this to a boil and then I'm gonna let it simmer for about 20 to 25 minutes. While our soup is a simmering, we are going to turn out our dough. Now we're gonna transfer our dough onto a piece of parchment paper. Lift it up and in. All right, so while our bread is baking, let's go back to our soup. This part's really easy. We're just gonna use an immersion blender and blend it up. I'm just gonna keep this on a very low heat until we're ready to eat it. Our bread is good to go. It's all cooled down. It looks beautiful. Now it's time to slice this up, take those vegan cheeses out of the fridge, and assemble our gourmet grilled cheese. That is good. It's got the meltiness. It's got the gooiness and the stretchiness. The Gouda and the cheddar are so flavorful and delicious, and it's very reminiscent of actual cheese. You have been properly spoiled today. You got 3 brand new vegan grilled cheese recipes. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a glorious day. We're not cutting around any corners for this. We're gonna make a delicious homemade bed. We're gonna make we're gonna make our own delicious, we're going to make a home. All right, so now we wanna add a bunch of our, all right, so now we're gonna, so, okay. Now you're gonna wanna hide, okay, so now we're gonna wanna, all right, this is all right, so she's looking nice and foamy. All right, so we're looking, all right.